Police Joe, or the Art of Jiu-Jitsu. Now here we see the famous Mel Bruno, a judo practitioner from the 1950s, attacking a jiu-jitsu practitioner. And he's demonstrating how he would defend against a Western-style kata and also the use of a knife. Here he defeats a knife-wielding assailant. Again, striking his lead hand and countering with a jiu. The head stops Mel Bruno dead in his tracks. His hand crippling his left hand and preventing him from attacking further. Now, a Western style boxer, the same technique, crippling his left hand with a blow from the stick. A thrust to the stomach. Stopping him, just stopping him dead in his tracks against a would-be wrestler. Now, from a person wielding a similar weapon, thrusting at him with either a bayonet or a stick. Striking to the wrist and countering. The art of using the long stick originated in Japan over 400 years ago. It was invented by a samurai swordsman known as Muto Konosuke. He is famous for defeating the legendary Miyamoto Musashi. However, he was originally defeated by Musashi, and they both used Boken in a match. But after performing and perfecting his techniques repeatedly, he had a second match with Musashi. Now, the Jo in modern times has been adapted by the police, and it is known as Kabo Toho. The police techniques actually evolved from 12 basic blows developed by Muso Konosuke into 70 advanced techniques. Here you can see the way in which the stick is grasped and used from alternative knives, striking to various vital points. A senior practitioner shows how to use the jiu effectively against a sword. Now, another thing to keep in mind is that the jiu was used oftentimes in a situation where non-lethal results were required. Here you can see the intricacies of the movement of the jiu, and its relationship to the katana of the samurai sword. Knocking down, actually uchi ototi, knocking down the opponent's sword and countering. Now a tying up movement, knocking his sword away and countering. Here we have the practitioner slipping the blow of the sword and then countering with the jiu. Next, driving the opponent away, pinning his sword to the ground, countering with a strike to the body, shutting down motion, getting inside the opponent's range so he can no longer use his weapon. And this one, a strike to the wrist and the rib simultaneously from underneath. Next, the jiu practitioner assumes a hostile ogamae. The spinning motion is a distraction technique. Again, coming from underneath and pinning the opponent's sword to the ground. All ways of using the jiu against a swordsman. Striking to the wrist and thrusting, avoiding the opponent's strike, and then another crushing blow to the head. Here we have a innocent looking enough kamae. The opponent appears defenseless. That's why he has the jewel above his head, and then you can see how quickly he can turn it to his advantage. Yes, turns it to his own advantage. Now, the next martial art or weapon art we have to show you is the short stick, also known as tanbo. Now, the short stick sort of evolved in the 17th and 18th century environment and was associated with the art of jiu-jitsu. Now, jiu-jitsu originally was on the battlefield, but then later became sort of a police-style method of controlling unruly samurai in the nightclub district. Here we have a defense against a thrust, a strike to the wrist, followed by a kote gaishi, a wrist twist, flipping the opponent to his stomach where it can no longer come.